The end of the Crown's fourth season saw the royal family heading towards a dramatic season 5. Marriages are under strain and traditions are beginning to crumble. It's a knotty situation that we'll try to untangle to prepare you for the series' return.
I refuse to be blamed any longer for this grotesque misalliance!
At the heart of season 3 is a growing tension between Elizabeth II and Charles over the role of the crown and the impact of the institution on his personal life. From a young age, he feels his fate is out of his hands, and he thinly veils those concerns in his first speech as the Prince of Wales, triggering a direct confrontation with the Queen.
Mummy, I have a voice.
Let me let you into a secret. No one wants to hear it.
Charles sees more of himself in his great-uncle David, aka King Edward, a royal who threw away duty and abdicated the throne to marry the twice-divorced Wallis Simpson. While the former king saw out his dying days estranged from the royal family, his vision of a more modern monarchy does strike a chord with Charles.
And that meeting occurred when you were Prince of Wales.
Yes, a role that I also very much hope to redefine. I had my own ideas, my own opinions. My own philosophy.
Charles's love life causes further drama in season 3, putting him on a collision course with the throne. He starts seeing Camilla Shand, and while she brings out the best in him,
gotcha!
Camilla is already in a relationship with a mutual friend, Andrew Parker Bowles, although the pair keep things open and flirty. Andrew even has a brief fling with Princess Anne. Anne warns the family of this looming situation.
As long as he's prepared for there to always be three in the marriage.
And Lord Mountbatten and the Queen Mother conspire to split the pair up. Charles is given a naval post, and Camilla and Parker Bowles are encouraged to marry. As we enter season 4, Charles's love for Camilla hasn't dimmed, not even with the arrival of Diana Spencer. But after wowing the royal family on a trip to Balmoral, Diana is deemed a suitable match and an engagement follows. However, even now, she senses clear feelings between Charles and Camilla, hinting at trouble to come. The following years are turbulent. Although Diana dazzles on the world stage, she upsets the publicity-shy royals with her growing celebrity, echoing the Queen's battles with her spotlight-hogging sister Margaret back in season 1 and 2. But unhappiness brews under Diana's surface as she wrestles with an eating disorder and argues with Charles over his affair with Camilla.
Camilla is who I want. That is where my loyalties lie. That is who my priority is.
As a result, Diana's own affairs follow, notably with James Hewitt, and her attempts at reconciliation with Charles are repeatedly met with embarrassment and anger.
I'm starting to properly loathe
you! But what's taking you so long? The rest of us have been there for some time!
But, despite the pair's unhappiness becoming an open secret, the Queen refuses to allow a split, as it would not be fitting for the future head of the Church of England to divorce.
And if I want to separate?
You will not separate, or divorce, or let the side down in any way. And if one day you expect to be king...
I do.
Then might I suggest you start to behave like one.
The war between what the heart desires and what the institution allows has been building from season 1. We saw it in the early years of the Queen's marriage to Philip, as a man of ambition learned to accept a supporting role as the world's most famous husband. An identity crisis that persists into later seasons, as we see him hungering for the adventure of the moon landings and even questioning his faith. Or consider the Queen's sister Margaret, who fell in love with Peter Townsend. Unfortunately, he was a divorcee, blacklisted by the Crown, and his swift exit was engineered. Instead, a heartbroken Margaret fell into a relationship with rakish photographer Tony Armstrong Jones. Despite causing a minor scandal with the publication of his photos of her, the pair marry in season 2. By season 3, Margaret and Tony's marriage is on the rocks. He loses himself in his work as she finds solace in an affair with Roddy Llewellyn, and the occasional music number. While bringing her level head to all these events, the Queen continues to navigate her own setbacks and challenges. From the discovery of a Russian spy in the royal household to grieving tragic deaths after a mining spoil pit collapses on Aberfan. By season 4, the Queen has reigned for almost 30 years and finds herself challenged by changing times. Her children grow unhappy in their respective lives, social unrest in the UK sees people questioning ageing institutions, and on the global stage, the Falklands War and South African apartheid see her clashing with her Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher.
We are the same age after all.
Really?
Just 6 months between us.
Oh? And who is the senior?
I am.
But by 1990, that tense relationship had thawed into mutual respect. In season 5, a new Prime Minister is in place, John Major, and we rejoin the family at the start of the 90s. The Queen is entering her late 60s and is about to witness one of the most notorious and public breakups of the 20th century. Will the monarchy prevail? Find out when The Crown returns to Netflix on November 9th.